बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम। आई एम डॉक्टर अहमद नोमान फ्रॉम यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एजुकेशन अटक कैंपस, एंड टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड इंडस्ट्री। सो वी विल कवर दिस हाइड्रोक्लोरिक इंडस्ट्री इन सेवरल पार्ट्स, एंड टुडे इज आवर first lecture on this topic. So let's start. First, before we start the lecture, just let's briefly discuss about the content outline which we will discuss today and in our coming lectures. So the first lecture today is about the introduction of the HCl, and in today we will discuss like what is HCl and what are the, for example, physical properties of HCl, and we will also discuss the history of HCl, like when how long before HCl was used and produced, and then we will also discuss about the natural sources of HCl. And after that we will discuss some general characteristics of HCl and also the toxicity of HCl to the human beings. So these are this introductory part will be covered today in this first lecture, and in then next coming lectures so we will discuss about the global HCl production and its application in different industries and different areas. And then we will also have some overview of some really important chemical properties or chemical reactions of HCl, and then we will discuss about the methods which are commonly used for the industrial scale production of hydrochloric acid. And at the last we will discuss about some major uses and applications of hydrochloric acid in worldwide. So first we will have some introduction about what is HCl, and then we will move further. So HCl is normally a clear, colorless acid, but it depends on the concentration of actually the HCl. For the low concentration normally it's colorless, but if its concentration is about 25% or like the maximum is, for example, like 37%, so then it has a slightly yellow color. But for dilute HCl and normal HCl which is used in industry, it is a clear colorless liquid. And HCl has a very strong, actually pungent smell, which is very familiar, and although it's very toxic. So if we have to define what is HCl, so we can say that HCl is a solution of hydrochloride gas in water, and in it is also known as muriatic acid or spirit of salt. These are the historical names of the hydrochloric acid. Another very important property of HCl is it is highly corrosive chemicals. Although it has many applications in industry, but it has a very corrosive nature. So its use there are specific kind of materials which are required, otherwise it corrodes the instruments where they are used. And based on the its acidity, it is known as a strong acid, as it completely dissociates in aqueous solution.
An acid is a substance that produces hydrogen ions when dissolved in water. Hydrogen chloride is an example of a common and important acid. When hydrogen chloride gas dissolves in water, it forms hydrochloric acid. Hydrogen chloride is very soluble in water and is completely dissociated. It is therefore a strong electrolyte.
The molecule hydrogen chloride is formed by sharing a pair of electrons between a hydrogen atom and a chlorine atom. Hydrogen has one electron in the valence shell, while chlorine has seven electrons in the valence shell. Chlorine being more electronegative than hydrogen, the shared electrons are pulled closer towards chlorine. As a result, the chlorine atom gets a small negative charge represented as delta negative, and the hydrogen atom gets a small positive charge represented as delta positive.
Briefly go through some of the physical properties of HCl. The molar mass of HCl is 36.46 gram per mole, while its density is around 1.1 gram per centimeter cube. When we talk about melting and boiling points of HCl, so that depends on the physical condition, for example, the concentration of HCl and the atmospheric pressure. So when measured at 760 mmHg pressure, so the for 20% HCl, the boiling point is around 109 degrees Celsius and the melting point is around 62 degrees Celsius. And when we increase the concentration from 20 to 31% of HCl, then it's actually both melting and boiling point decrease to 83 degrees Celsius and 46 degrees Celsius respectively. And for the concentrated HCl, which has a concentration of 37%, the boiling point of HCl is around 51 degrees Celsius, while the melting point is minus 25 degrees Celsius.
History of hydrochloric acid goes back to around 800 AD when Jabir bin Hayyan actually used it for the first time, and after that there was not much work that is reported on the use of hydrochloric acid till the 15th century when Basilius Valentinus actually produce it from rock salt and green vitriol. Back then it was called acidum salt, some people called it muriatic acid, and it is also known as spirits of salt. In the 16th century it was first formally described as hydrochloric acid by Libavius, who prepared it by heating salt in clay crucible. And then later it was synthesized from the chemical similar substances, which is common salt and sulfuric acid, by Rudolf in the 17th century. And after the synthesis by Rudolf Glober in the 17th century, it was used by different chemists, including Glober himself and also Priestley and Davy, for their scientific research. And after that it become very common, and since 17th century it is used in all over the world.
So the hydrochloric acid, which is nowadays used commercially in so many applications, so definitely it can be prepared in the laboratory by different methods, which we will discuss in our coming lectures. But HCl is also present naturally in our earth and our atmosphere. So when we talk about the natural sources of HCl, so normally, broadly speaking, there are three sources, for example, volcanoes, methyl chloride, and some sea aerosols. So the first one is its emission from volcanic eruptions, and due to the nature of volcanic eruption, it is very hard to predict that how much HCl is released in our atmosphere from the volcanic activities. But different estimates have been made, and it is generally estimated that around 0.8 million to around 7.6 million tons of HCl is released in our atmosphere every year due to some volcanic eruptions, which is quite a significant amount. And the large amount of HCl which is naturally produced is due to the action of actually methyl chloride with the hydroxyl radicals in atmosphere. So methyl chloride is produced actually by some marine plants and microorganisms, and it is also produced on land when we do the combustion of different vegetative materials. So that methyl chloride, either it is produced by marine plants or organisms, or when it is produced through the combustion of vegetation. So that methyl chloride actually reacts with hydroxyl radicals in the atmosphere and produce hydrogen chloride. And when we predict about the amount of HCl which is produced by methyl chloride per year, so and by different estimate it's around 5.6 million tons of actually methyl chloride is produced every year. And when we calculate the conversion of methyl chloride to HCl, so it can be estimated about 4 million tons of hydrogen chloride which is produced from methyl chloride every year naturally. And the third main source, natural source of hydrogen chloride is its production from the reaction of sea salt aerosols with atmospheric acids. So these are the three main natural sources of the hydrochloric acid in our atmosphere. And when we talk about the natural sources or natural presence of HCl in our atmosphere or in our environment, then we cannot forget to mention the presence of HCl in human digestive systems and different other animals, especially the mammals. So we know that there is some gastric acid which is produced in our stomach, which helps in actually the digestion of food. So that gastric acid actually contains HCl. So the HCl is produced by the gastric mucosa of mammals' digestive systems, including the human beings. And that actually presence of hydrochloric acid in that gastric juices which are prepared synthesized by the gastric mucosa, they acidify the stomach contents and help in the digestion of food and get rid of secretion in the mammals and especially human beings. So HCl actually play a significant role in the digestion of food in human beings and the other mammals. And when we talk about the pH level of actually the hydrochloric acid, so normally if we talk about the strong acid, its pH is around 1. However, in our stomach, because there are some other substances are also present, so that gastric acid which contains HCl, its pH is around 3. And normally an adult human actually produce around 1.5 liter per day of the gastric juices, and the normal concentration of HCl is around 0.05 to actually 0.1 normal in that gastric juice. So this is a very important example of natural occurrence of HCl in our in human bodies. So now let's briefly go through a short animation and see how HCl is actually produced inside the gastric mucosa.
Hydrochloric acid is produced in parietal cells through a complex series of reactions. Carbon dioxide diffuses into the parietal cell, and the enzyme carbonic anhydrase catalyzes a reaction between the carbon dioxide and water to form carbonic acid. Carbonic acid dissociates into bicarbonate ion and hydrogen ion, and the bicarbonate ion is transported back into the bloodstream. An ion exchange molecule in the plasma membrane exchanges bicarbonate going out for chloride coming in. The hydrogen ions are actively transported into the duct of the gastric gland, and the negatively charged chloride ions diffuse with the positively charged hydrogen ions. Potassium ions are countertransported into the parietal cell in exchange for hydrogen ions. The net result is production of hydrochloric acid in the parietal cells and its secretion into the duct of the gastric gland.
Now just discuss few general characteristics of HCl. As we discussed earlier, that it's a colorless liquid. So HCl is non-flammable, and mostly it's colorless, but if it's in a higher concentration, or the concentrated HCl is light yellow. And when the concentration of HCl is above 25%, so it is known as fuming HCl and a strong acid concentrated HCl. Normally the concentrated HCl is around 36.5%. HCl reacts with different compounds, and it especially reacts with chromates, permanganates and persulfates to generate chlorine, and it reacts with metal peroxide to form its chloride and chlorine. It has a very pungent odor, and it is highly corrosive, and its fumes are really dangerous for both humans and other animals. And the inhalation of large amount of HCl actually can cause the death of the animals, and definitely human beings as well. HCl khud jo hai wo explosive nahi hai, it is inflammable. लेकिन बिकॉज इट्स हाईली क्रोसिफ इन नेचर, सो अगर स्पेशली जब ये मेटल के साथ रिएक्ट करता है तो इट प्रोड्यूस हाइड्रोजन, एंड दैट हाइड्रोजन इज हाईली फ्लेमेबल एंड कैन रिजल्ट इन द एन एक्सप्लोजन इफ इट्स मिक्स्ड विद द एयर. देर आर वेरी फ्यू मटीरियल विच आर रेजिस्टेंट टू HCl, एंड सम ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स इंक्लूड glass, which is acid resistant, some acid resistant ceramics, some rubber linings, and some other compounds such as vinyl chloride and polyethylene.
Just have a look at the bottle of hydrochloric acid. So we can see that there are four labels which are present on that bottle. So I have put these enlarged those labels here, and you should know what those labels actually mean. The first label there on the bottle was about corrosion. So it is used for two basically reasons. So one is that for a chemical which is dangerous for the skin of the person is also the chemicals which can cause corrosion. So for that they use this kind of symbol. If you find that kind of a symbol on any bottle, so you should avoid contact with that kind of chemicals. Then second is the environment, label represents environment, and that shows actually the aquatic environment, which shows that specific chemical is toxic to marine organisms, both aquatic plants and animals. And the third symbol hai, that is about health hazard. So which means that such a compound which have that kind of symbol that shows that this compound is toxic and it can cause cancer, for example. It can cause gene mutation, it can have some reproductive issues, and also that such if there is such symbol is present, which means that by the inhalation of the fumes of that specific chemical, it can be toxic to the human beings. And the fourth symbol, which shows the skull and bones, it shows very acute toxicity. That if that symbol is present on a chemical, that means that if you inhale or digest that chemical in a significant amount, it may result in sudden death of a person, and that amount, that chemical is really toxic. So, and you can find that all of these four symbols are present on the hydrochloric acid, which means it is highly corrosive, it is toxic to environment, it is it causes different health hazards, and it can cause the death of the human beings. So when we discuss about the toxicity of the any compound, so we mostly categorize the toxicity of different chemicals into the allowable concentration, like mild symptoms, moderate symptom, and serious symptoms. And we categorize that how much concentration is okay, it's not dangerous for animals or human beings, and at what concentration it can be slightly toxic, it can be moderately toxic, or it can be lethal. So when we categorize HCl based on its toxicity to human beings, so if its concentration is less than 5 milligram per liter, or which we call 5 ppm, so that can be okay if it's not very long term, but for short term, if the concentration around 5 ppm is not really toxic for human beings. But if its concentration is above 10 to around 50 ppm, so that can be slightly toxic, and it can have symptoms of, for example, coughing, sneezing, or like a runny nose. लेकिन जब आप इसकी concentration increase होती है, for example, अगर किसी person जो है वो exposed होता है for around half an hour, HCl concentration around more than 50 to 100 milligram per liter, and that can actually result in difficult in breathing. उसको सांस में issue होगी, and आँखें open करने में, chest में pain शुरू हो जाएगी, and that can actually cause in result in death अगर आप इस जो concentration का around 1 hour तक अगर आप उसको expose करते हैं. And then if you increase the concentration to around 100 around 1000 ppm, so that is actually 1000 ppm means around 1 gram in liter, so that is actually really toxic, and it can cause death in around half an hour. And if a person is exposed to that high concentration of HCl, so it will be impossible for the person, mostly to saans lene mein pareshani hogi aur unconsciousness bhi ho sakti hai. And normally the concentration agar aap 1 gram se 2 gram ke per liter se jo hai 1000 ya 2000 ppm jisko bolte hain, agar usse zyada ho to that actually can cause actually immediate death of a person. So that shows that how toxic HCl can be for human beings. And that is actually the first, jab aap inhale kar rahe hain ya through like fumes hain ya aap usko direct ingest kar rahe hain. But other than that, it's also very toxic to the skin, and agar aap isko even those kam concentration mein use karte hain for long term, it can cause actually the skin cancer for long term usage. So precautions should be used while you are working with any acid, and especially the strong acid like HCl. So I think it's sufficient for today's lecture, and we will inshallah continue from here onwards in our next lecture. And in case in this lecture you have some confusion or problem in understanding any specific thing, So please let me know and I will try to clear it for you guys. Okay, thank you so much for listening and for your patience, and Allah Hafiz.